Welcome to Move Ahead at Home, a collection of instructional videos created to help learners of all ages deepen their understanding of mathematical concepts. My name is Glenna Tabor. For the past few decades, I've worked with K-12 schools across the United States as an educational consultant. I'm going to show you how to use just a few resources to play math games that are simple and fun. Plus, they will help your learners get what they need to succeed. We're going to increase the rigor of learning math concepts with games because we're going to move ahead with integers. The first game is called Integer Identification. This game is most appropriate for 6th through 8th graders, but with manipulatives such as these, children in 4th and 5th grades can also learn about integers by playing this game. Let's start where I needed to when I began teaching 6th graders. What's an integer? An integer is any whole number that's not a fraction. An integer can be positive, negative, or zero. 25 is an integer. Negative 25 is an integer, but 25.25 is not an integer. Wait a minute, has it been a while since you've talked about integers? Hang in there, because with a few manipulatives, everyone in the house will soon be an expert at combining integers. And identifying integers, you'll need at least 15 red and 15 white of the same item, such as buttons or red paper or insects. You can also use 15 of a lighter color and 15 of a darker color. I use these counters, and if you're magnifying the screen, you're right, they are plastic roaches. The roaches with the red stripe on the backs are negative, and the ones without a red stripe are positive. Now that you have awesomely cool manipulatives that will make you want to learn about integers, we're going to practice creating integers. Remove the face cards from your deck of cards and the tens and shuffle them. The jokers, remove those too, but leave in the aces as ones. Parents, grandparents, and siblings, you can play too, because that makes competition and it makes it more fun to play. The red cards will represent negative and the black cards will represent the positive integers. Let's take our first one and see. It is three of spades. That is a black number. So it would be a positive three. I would represent that with ladybugs, or I could represent it with roaches, or I could represent it with something that is lighter color. The first person to represent and then put their hands on their shoulders will win that round. Wait a second. If you've watched other Move Ahead at Home videos, you know that a player can't win a card or a point unless they can explain how they know they have the correct answer and they support it. I know this represents positive three. One, two, three. Practice this. Identify those integers, represent them concretely, and you'll be ready to move ahead with integer combination. Thank you for watching this video. If you like what you saw and want more, visit my website, glennatabor.com. There are over 100 games there you can download all for free. The games are fun. They teach the concepts your children need to be learning right now. If you have any questions or you'd like to see games for other concepts, please let me know in the comments section below. If you like this game, be sure to click the subscribe button so you'll know every time a new game is added. See you next time as we move ahead at home.